Hey guys, have you ever heard of the one wheel? It's pretty much my favorite thing ever. In fact, as an inventor, I would be happy, so happy, if I invented anything even half as cool as this. Don't believe me? It's also Adam Savage's favorite thing.
You guys know how much I love the one wheel.
Ran from Corridor Digital.
This is the one wheel, pretty much the best electric vehicle that's not a car.
Even Sam, one of the gravity jet suit pilots, loves one wheels. And this whole social distancing thing, using a one wheel is a great way to destroy boredom and get away from people. I love it. But you know what really sucks? If you're out on a really long ride and you run out of juice, what do you do? It's pretty heavy. So in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how you can recharge your one wheel at an EV charge station. Now, you might remember, we recently built a half-scale Cybertruck. Well, while building this, we learned a thing or two, including the electrical standard for EV charging, specifically the SAE J1722 charge port. As it turns out, this plug actually just puts out 240 volts AC, but it does have a protection circuit, so it's got an extra pin in there that acts as a signal wire to tell the EV charger whether or not it's safe to put out power to charge your vehicle. If we can fake that signal wire, we can charge our one wheel using one of these. And since the one wheel charger already accepts 100 to 240 volts AC, all we need to do is make the adapter. Let's get to it. All right, so to make this, we can actually reuse the circuit diagram from our half-scale Cybertruck. In fact,
we only need this part right here.
Now, remember, I'm a mechanical engineer, not electrical engineer. So really, I have no business doing electronics like this, let alone high voltage. But it is just two resistors and a diode, so I think I can handle it. Hopefully, I don't have to call Bogdan.
All right, so the diode is a 1N4003. The only issue is I have no idea where we keep diodes up here. Let's skip the resistors because I do know where those are, right here. All right, so we're looking for a 2.7 kilo ohm resistor and a 1.3 kilo ohm resistor. 1.3 kilo ohm, perfect. And we also need a 2.7, 2, 2.2, 3, 3.3. Well, we can do 2 1.3s and a 100. I think that works.
Ta-da! All right, let's test out my homemade resistor. As long as my math is right, and it must have been because I'm a hacksmith, we should get 2.7 kiloohms right here. 1.5. All right, let's try this again. We want 2.7, so we take 1.3, 1, and then 1 plus 1.3 is 2.3 plus 400, so we could do two 200s.
There we go, and it's a W this time. All right, let's try that again. Got my voltmeter, my multimeter, sorry. And now we have, 2.7 kiloohms! So now we can use this resistor and the 1.3 resistor, and we still need that diode. And it turns out we have two drawers down here called 4007, and they look like diodes to me. So the real question is, why do we have this many 4007 diodes, and why did we use 4003? What is the difference? So the difference between these diodes is mainly the reverse breakdown voltage. 1007 can withstand a higher reverse voltage. Usually the higher voltage diodes in series have a higher V forward, lower capacitance, and longer TRR. Okay, so I understand some of these words, but I have no idea. I'm just gonna call Bogdan.
Hello?
Hey Bogdan. I can't find a 1N4003 diode. Can I just use a 1N4007 diode?
They're both having 4007, but there's one, like, Ziploc, I think it was.
Oh, it's a Ziploc.
Probably a Digi Ziploc.
All right, I'll check the Ziploc. Thank you.
Have fun. Awesome.
Oh. I know, I said I didn't want to call Bogdan, but in my defense, how else would I have known that there's actually 4003 diodes hanging out with a 4007? There's totally no 4003 diodes here. Any ideas where that DigiKey bag would be? So far not look. Ooh, are these flash tubes? Oh no, they're reed switches. Alright, so you're telling me I can use 4007?
You should be able to, yes.
Thanks, Bogdan. Alright, so that was a whole bunch of running around for potentially nothing, because apparently 4007 and 4003 are close enough. 4007 is just more expensive and better. And we just have to solder these two guys together. I attached that wire to the J1277 port, and as soon as you short these two wires together, which also connects back to Earth, we should have power. All right, so this has already taken way too long in the video, so I've gone ahead and I've made my little adapter. Basically, we plug this into ground, and we plug this into this right here. We'll get 240 volts out right here, which means we can power the one wheel. So let's box it up. I want the plug to come out one side, and I want an outlet on the other side so we can literally just plug in the one wheel. It's beautiful. Basically, you plug in your EV charge port here. 220 comes out here, but only if you press the on button. Now, in case you want to make one of these yourself, you can check out our full circuit diagram on maker.io, sponsored by DigiKey. Before we go out and blow up a charge port, we should double check to make sure the box works the way we think it does. And to do that, we can use our Cybertruck charging port, which just plugs into a normal 220 volt outlet, like so. Now, as long as this works and I didn't wire anything wrong, I can go ahead and plug it in there. And hypothetically, I should get 240 volts out of this side. And yes, we have 240 volts. Why does it sound like something's melting? All right, false alarm, everything looks good. I think it was just the sound of the plastic rubbing on the steel table, which means I have no fear in plugging in my one-wheel charger. Plug her in, boom. It's charging, red light on there. All right, everything's good, which means it's time to actually take this and plug it in to a real EV charger and make sure it still works. Shoo! Ha. I probably shouldn't go and try and test this at 1 a.m. because if there's any security at any of the EV charge points, they'll probably be like, what the hell are you doing with this box and stuff? So we'll have to do that tomorrow morning. All right, now it's time to go test to see if I can charge my one wheel off of an EV charge station. Let's go. Boop. Is that a cat? It's a black cat. Hello, kitty. Hi. Hello. You're so cute. You're like a skinny version of my cat. There we go. All right, let's try this out. power button. And look, we have power. Need to plug this into here. Light is green. And I think it's working. Charging. 0.2 kilowatts. Plugged in, 29 minutes till full charge. So I have to wait here for a bit. Now you might be wondering, wouldn't it be easier to just charge your one wheel from a normal outlet? Well, you're probably right, but I wanted to do this video to show you guys how you can use a publicly available electrical standard to hack the system. It's not really hacking the system because I have to pay for this using a charge point, but it's kind of cool being able to use something designed to charge an EV to charge your one wheel. Anyway, thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe.